beloved in holy matrimony, which is commanded by St. Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, Trevor and Anne-Marie, these two have now come to be joined. If any man or woman can show just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let him or her speak now or thereafter hold your peace. Today, here with all of you, I get 60 seconds. The secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed. If either of you know any impediment, why want you to be assured that if any person are joined together otherwise than as God would so allow, the marriage is not for her. In sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her, so long as you both shall live.
I do.
Anne-Marie Shallow, will you have this man, Trevor Joseph, to be thy wedded husband, to live according to God's holy ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you obey him and serve him, love him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And I will now ask, who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
Vivian Jackson. And also?
Anne-Marie Shallow.
No. Alright.
Make a shallow.
Make a shallow. So I want you all to know that she is given away. She is given away.
And who gave this man to this woman?
Angela James.
Right, so please give her. Everyone just stretch your hands towards that. I'm going to do that this way. So Father, we thank you that marriage still remains honorable among all men. I thank you that Trevor and Anne-Marie now have brought their seed of love and also the soil to receive each other's seed of love. I want to say thank you. And I pray, God, you would bless this union. And as they give it to you, that they will hold the promise that you are faithful to keep that which we have entrusted to you. And Lord, we entrust them both to you today. In the name of Jesus. And everybody says,
I want you all to watch each other eyeball to eyeball.
I feel you all better do it.
You all see what's going on inside there? Okay. No. So, as you all watch each other, Trevor, you repeat after me as you're going to speak these vows towards Anne-Marie at this time.
I, Trevor Joseph.
Take you, Anne-Marie Shallow.
To be my wedded wife.
To have her to hold. From this day forward.
For better.
For worse.
For richer.
For poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I pledge my vow.
Anne-Marie, watch him straight in his eyes, back us off now, repeat after me. I, Anne-Marie Shallow.
Take you, Trevor Joseph.
To be my wedded husband. To have her to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
And to obey.
Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. I pledge my vow. Alright, let's get those rings.
You all want to find a voice song in this kind of husky, sexy kind of thing.
No, keep holding each other, keep watching each other. Don't break the rank now. Not yet.
First time I ever hear our voice go down in that kind of husky kind of tone and all this type of stuff. Okay, ladies, it's a true part. Got a lot of rocks on it. Mr. Trevor is pleasing his wife already. Look like 24 karat gold.
With this ring,
I be wed,
and with all my worldly goods,
I deal thou,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Ghost,
Amen. After me and read.
With this ring,
I do well.
And with all my worldly goods,
I do endow.
In the name of the Father,
of the Son,
of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. No, where's the sound? Nice. This one below. Nice. Right. You ought to stretch your hands towards them again. Right where you are. And let's pray. And Father, we thank you once again. As they have vowed their vows, and as they have exchanged the tokens, God of the rings, the signature in itself, according to the law of Allah,
and you will be Lord of your rings.
And I want to thank you. Let's do that. I pray, God, as they hold fast to the covenant that they have vowed one with another. As you said, whether we go through the fire, whether we go through the flood, Lord,
and I pray, God, they would see to it that this be
as now they step into an understanding that now they would stand to tell another generation, come this way. This is the way to go.
Very box.
The whole analogy of this candle represents, Trevor, this candle represents Amnon in their individual position. Now you can never lose your individual position. Never. Because this is male, this is female. They're different. So you can never lose that. Marriage does not ask of you to give that up. It does not. What marriage asks of us to do is to become interdependent. One with another to become one. So this is what is going to happen. So now Amory is going to take hold of, because of marriage, both of them now is entering into this institution here called marriage. Now they are using their individual choice of will to trust the next individual with their seed love. So Amory is sowing her seed love in the soil of the heart of Trevor, and Trevor is sowing his seed love in the soil heart of Amory. But it could only be kept in what God has structured.
So bring your individual lives here to this one point here. Bring it to this point right here together. Now remove your individual and keep it right there. Now you tell me, should three candles be burning? Why? Because they're supposed to become one. Then what are they supposed to do with this? Blow it up. Nice. Now we have one lighting. What this means, after today, the law have just been activated for them to live interdependently one with another. So it's no longer living unto myself. But I choose, because I'm in this marriage fraternity or institution, to live on to my husband, to live on to my wife. Once we do that, I'm telling you, there is a sweetness that will always remain on your honey. You all with me? Because there are some moons that run out of the honey, you know. But you always want your moon to have honey. And the only way that could happen, keep it here lighting. So what we do as individuals now has a lot to do with how this flame is going to be kept lit. It's up to both of them now to keep this going. Both of them. So now they are no longer two, but they are on the journey of becoming this one. Let us, all of us who have been witnesses of this today, be encouragers to both of them. Check in on them. Say, how are you doing, Trev? How are you doing, Anne Marie? Still loving up the man? Still loving up the woman? Encourage them. We need this level of encouragement. Be an encourager of what God says is honorable amongst men. Even if yours may not have worked out, don't be a discourager of it. Be an encourager, because it is of God. We have messed up what is of God. It's not on God's side. It's on our side. So let us try and say, you know what, even if it didn't work for me, I want to see this work for you.
Next man I love. Peace each other. For as much as Trevor and Anne-Marie have consented together in holy wedlock, and before all of you, the witnesses, and before Almighty God, as they have vowed their vow and pledged their pledge and held hands and exchanged rings, and we prayed the prayers and we blessed them and we did the candle ceremonies and all this stuff, I just want to take this time to say right now, Mr. Trevor, you have taken yourself a wife. So now I want to give to you, Mr. and Miss Joseph, at this time, and I now pronounce you man and wife. Now, the next thing I'm going to say is that whatsoever God has joined together, let that man separate. Let me share this with you. Because both of them bear arms. After today, you ain't seen none of this openly. Today's lawful. So get your smartphone out, get your tablet out. Don't step in front of the professionals. So Mr. Trevor, in the presence of the witnesses, the angels of God and Almighty God, both of you are taken before him, you may kiss your bride. And somebody please send me a footage of it. Send me a footage. All right.
Sun, winds, and thunder, all that were gone. Pleasant good afternoon. I just want to say blessed good afternoon to Mr. and Mrs. Joseph. Congratulations on this new journey you are embarked on. I wish you God's blessing, God's speed. I wish that you put God first throughout everything that you do, especially in your relationship, because nothing is impossible with God. Amen. So peace up, bless up. All the best.
Hi, Shalom. Well, you know me. Plain, simple. Anyway, all the best, health, strength. This is it, finally you are here. You know, you always talk about you want to do this thing, and the day is here that, you know, you can get to do this thing. I'm proud of you. You know, being a Christian, I want to wish you long life, health, and prosperity. I want you to remember, keep Christ in the center of your marriage. When you have problems, talk to no one else but your husband, and with God, all things are possible. Remember, I'm a friend, I'm always here for you all. Blessings.
She was going through a rough time, and I said to her, it's going to get better. And one year I came to Trinidad, I heard about Trevor. And one year I came to Trinidad, and I met Trevor. And I will tell you, was the love at first sight. myself and Trevor, we're like, we knew one another for 30 something years. Our relationship hit it off right away. And whenever I call her, I'm like, but my man, but my man doing? And she said, God, you're right by my side. And before I can say anything to her, I will ask Trevor, how my woman treating you? And he said, good, good. So I would like to say this evening to my bestie, let's call him a Trinidad bestie, to my Trinidad bestie, Anne-Marie, and my newfound brother, Trevor, all the best, love, Anne-Marie. Watch yourself. Watch yourself. They get Trevor in trouble. Trevor, take care of Anne-Marie. Anne-Marie, take care of Trevor. This is love. This is the love. And I wish you all the best. All the best in my heart. I wish both of you all the best. Hip hip.
Right. One of Anne-Marie's best friends, Cheryl, stand back. Two days ago, I called Anne-Marie. I said, can I show you want to marry Trevor? And she, yes. I said, well, God be with you guys. Anne-Marie, Mr. Trevor, take good care of my friend. Continue, as I should say, continue taking good care of my friend. And we place everything in God's care. Amen.
I didn't plan to say anything this afternoon, but I thought it was important for me to say a few words, not only on my own behalf, but on behalf of his workers, his colleagues, some of his colleagues who are here this evening. I am very happy to be here this afternoon to share in this ceremony, bringing together two wonderful persons, right, Trevor and Anne-Marie. I have spent many times together with both, because you know Trevor is a very, well, should put it, he's a happy
goldfish.
He's a very, very happy going guy. And he's about love, he's about bringing people together, and he has a very, very good heart. And just last week, during my last week of my birthday, and I had a line on Trevor and Anne-Marie was there, and we would reciprocate whatever activity each other has. One of the things I would want to, that was very profound to me this afternoon during the ceremony, the pastor would have mentioned, I can't say the exact words, but I would paraphrase. And one of the things he mentioned is that when there are problems in a marriage, or by extension, even in a relationship, that both parties should work it out, and to try to avoid external personnel from intervening. That is so important. Because we live in a world where not everybody likes to see everybody happy. And we live in an environment where some persons, because of their own insecurities and failures, would want others to follow the same path. So we have to be very, very careful with that. But I'm confident that Anne-Marie and Trevor would not allow that to happen. And I also want to thank Anne-Marie, as a friend of Trevor, for the support she gives to Trevor, particularly when he went through a difficult period. She stood by him through thick and thin. And I think that we should give Amir a round of applause. And that is the kind of example, that is the kind of example
yes.
that we all should take from Anne-Marie. When you stand by your man, you have to stand firmly and give all the necessary support, and vice versa. Right? So it was important for me because I was asked if I'm going to the church, or if I'm coming to the reception. Some persons asked me. I said it's important for me to attend the ceremony because that is where the confirmation and that is where the witnesses are important. And to be part of that historic occasion. Because marriage is an historic occasion. So with these few words, I would like to congratulate Mr. and Mrs. Joseph, as Trevor reminded me a few days ago. So I have to get accustomed to that. And that was confirmed today. So let us give another round of applause to Mr. and Mrs. Joseph. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Really? I have one person.
And I'm so happy to know that you've been through the rough waters and now it's calm waters, and I wish both of you, your husband and yourself, all the best. Long life, health and strength. Yes.
Right, all the beer with me is not really a people person, so if I'm looking down to the ground, I just want to say I wish you all the best going forward. Continue being a light onto everyone around you all as a married couple. There's so much attacks going on people who are trying to be good. And especially people who are trying to be good in marriage as one of them. Alright? So, Mr. Trevor, alright? All the best going forward. Yeah, I don't even know how to express to you that the blessing that you have before you. And the same to you. Anne-Marie, you have an amazing life that you're setting an amazing example to each and every person here. And I want and wish the best in Jesus' name that we'll continue to not only walk and go forward, but to grow forward, right? And nothing. This is one truth that I learned in life, that nothing. Everything does work, but nothing does work well without Jesus.
Amen.
It will work, but it don't work properly. So. I just want to let you all know that I'm all the best going forward. I love you. And I love you too. Right? I love you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That sounds better. I was not going to speak, but my mother, and I'm a very obedient child, told me that I have to say something on behalf of her. So I don't know what she's going to say. But I think I know what she wants to say. But before I say what I think my mom wants to say, I want to bring up Anne-Marie's daughter, Kizzy, who wants to say something to her mom and her new stepfather.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
As introduced before, I am the daughter of the bride and the daughter of the groom. And I just want to thank God for this. Thank God for this occasion. Mommy,
let us clap our hands. Come on. Okay.
know that life has been rough for us as a family, but God is great.
Yes.
Amen. He has joy.
It's okay.
He has joined this union. And I think if it wasn't for God,
yes,
you all would not have met each other. And from the first time I met, I called him Daddy. From the first time I met Daddy, and I felt a joy in my heart,
yes,
to see my mother so happy with this gentleman, with this man of God. And Daddy, I just want to encourage you to continue to be a man of God. Continue to shine your light, as the previous speaker said. Continue to bring peace. Continue to set good examples in your home, to everyone that knows you. We all are looking to both of you now for precepts, for examples, as how to walk as man and woman, as husband and wife. Because as mentioned before, you know, so many things are happening in this world, especially with marriages and women and relationships and all kind of disastrous things. But when God is in the midst of everything, He's going to make it all right.
Yes. Amen.
So ensure that you have Almighty God in your business. And then everything else after, mommy, the scripture says, you know, love your husband. And to daddy, the scripture says, as Christ loved the church, He wants you to love your wife.
Amen.
So take care of each other with God in the midst, and everything is going to be all right. I wish you all the best. I will continue calling and making sure everything is all right with my mommy and daddy as usual. I love you both.
Love you.
And I wish you long life together. This is just the start. You have many, many more years together. And I pray that within the time that God puts you together, I pray that it stays together. As long as it may be. It could be 50 years. I wish it's 50 years. So let it be 50 years. Let that be your goal, that you should live together. Live together in sickness and in health, the vow says. You know, sometimes we get sick, and as we get sick, we don't want to take care of each other, you know, in riches or in poor. Sometimes, you know, Chaba might have a little $1, and you know, you might get a little upset, but remember the vow.
Yes.
When there is little, still make it work. And when there is much, still make it work. So all the best in Almighty name.
If I know that's what I had to come after, I would have gone first. Because if anybody who knows me, my name is Merlin. I am Anne Marie's little sister. And if anybody knows me, I don't cry. I'm the happy one. I'm the excited one. I'm the one that when Merlin comes down is like fun, fun, fun. So I'm going to give you guys a little story, very short. 6 years ago, I came to Trinidad for Carnival. And I get, you know, out of the airport, see Anne-Marie and this man. So who is this man? I set the silver on his hand. I said, what? Right away he said, hello, sister. No, I said, hey, I get respect. So the next thing I knew, dropped my suitcase. He said, well, sis, we're going partying. I said, yeah, that's my kind of party.
So we went to this party, and that whole carnival weekend, it was party, party, party. From that day, I knew I like Trevor. Because I like party, party, party. But I want to say to Trevor, I didn't like it just because of the party, you know. I fell in love with you when you stood with this woman here, Miss Omega Shallow. Besides my brothers, okay, I have Nora Shallow, I have David Austin, I have Samuel Austin, and I have Felix Jackson. You see this guy here, Trevor Joseph? He has stood by my mom when my brothers were not able to get here at the time, and when my sister was not able to because she was at work. He stood here by my mom. They say, honor your mother and thy father so that you're
in the land of the living.
And when the man loves the woman and the mother, especially my mother, that's good enough for me. I don't know about you, but that's good enough for me. My sister, as you all know, is the most caring person. I fuss over my sister a lot. I really, really do. And today, going in the car, I had to apologize. I say, Annie, I fuss over you a lot. Right? She say, yeah, but I like it. And I fussed with her all day because I said, you do so much for everyone, Anne-Marie. I call her Annie. You do so much, Anne-Marie. Just sit down and be the queen and relax and rest your voice. Every minute she get up, she, you all do this, all do that, carry this over, bring this here. I said, sit down. It didn't happen. But Anne-Marie, you know how I fuss over you? Because when I was younger, you fuss over me. So guess what? Payback. It's sisterhood. But I want to say to my sister and my brother, I have four brothers and now I have a fifth one. Thank you for allowing me to be here with you on this day. Thank you for opening up your home to all the friends and family that has been in their home, outside their home. Thank you for loving your family the way you have. Trevor, thank you for loving us and putting up with us the way you have. And trust me, it's not going to get any better. I also want to say that I wish you guys the best. I know you guys are good. You guys are really good together. Continue to be the good people that you are, because you guys are the best example for me, my two girls, and your nieces, Anne-Marie. We all love you. We look up to you. Isn't she beautiful today?
Yes.
And as someone was saying, a song came into my head. I can't stop saying too good enough, but I want to say, stand by your man. That's it.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. All right, I like how I hear that, man. On behalf of my wife and I, I want to thank everyone for coming out this day and giving us the support, because, you know, the good Lord says, let the light shine through us. And I hope this afternoon you can see a lot of light shining through myself and my wife. Yes. Mrs. Joseph. Yeah. Thank you for coming. Right? I want us to understand that we'll all have our trials, we'll all have our tribulations, but with God, all things are possible. I want us to turn to each and everyone here this afternoon and said, I say this word, I love you.
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 Right.
Because I want love in the house. Love in the house. Love in your house. Love in everybody's house. The theme of my wedding today is love. I want us to understand that. Love. Because through love, we can conquer all. I don't have much more to say. Because right now, what is going through my mind, but I'm going to say, I'm ready for a drink. I'm trying to say drink. Right? We talk bad manners, but there's a procedure. I have to follow the procedure. But I want everybody here this afternoon to enjoy and continue to enjoy life. Because God is good all the time. Not sometimes, all the time. We love you all. Have a blessed afternoon. Thank you.
So you ready?
Yeah, go ahead,
Gigi. Take it away.
So he's asking when he goes down,
if he's, he the timer, has a timer, and he's down there more than a specific time, then he will need some help. But I wanted to reassure him that Mrs. Joseph is also a professional swimmer.
So he good has.
Yes, I believe that. I believe that. Because I can recall sometime in the world you would have given some advice to people. So, yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, let your attention be right on front of the.
And it's right?
Straight overhead.
Overhead.
So where did they get
trained? Yes. Yeah. You know, so. Just hold on with DJ.
Not
too
hard.
Not
too hard. All right. Music DJ. Not too hard.
Yes.
Not too hard.
Please, all single ladies. Single ladies, this opportunity is once in a lifetime, isn't it? This one, this day, this will never occur with Mr. and Mrs. Joseph. Once in a lifetime. You may go to all your wedding function, but remember, Mr. and Mrs. Joseph, once in a lifetime. They try to get Mrs. Joseph's sister out of.
But he's not here right now, they're not married.
Sis, I'm very sorry, but I may have to give you some instruction. Could you take a seat, please? Thank you very much. It is all good. Any more single ladies in the house? Any more single ladies in the house? You said DJ have the single ladies song? Come on. Start. Come on, ladies, come on.
Trinbago.